This week on Coyote Country, we set our sights on what arguably has to be the most anticipated hunt of the 2015 season, as we backpack into the rugged Rocky Mountains in search of the prestigious Bighorn Rams. With Zipperlip Creek Camp marked as our destination, and a mission to erase the painful memories, well, let's just call them mishaps from last season's hunt, we needed to find more rams. We just needed the moon and stars to all line up and the sheep gods to throw us down a lucky bone. This hunt could be forever known as the Redemption Ram. Now sit back, relax, enjoy, and let our sweat, bruises, and blisters bring this hunt to you. Hi there and welcome to Coyote Country. I don't even know where to start as we have so much to say and so little time. But before we get to the action, there's just a few things that we wanted to say.
First off, if we look familiar, there's a good chance that you may have likely caught us on an episode of The Search Season 2, right here on Wild TV during the spring and summer of 2015.
That's right, and as luck would have it, Coyote Country was voted by you, the viewers, as a Canadian winner.
We can tell you firsthand that we were super excited when we were announced as the lucky winners, and we wanted to send out a huge thanks to all our family, friends, fans, and co-workers that voted faithfully for us each and every week.
So secondly, don't let the name Coyote Country fool you. As you just saw in our intro, coyotes are a huge passion of ours. Some might even argue an obsession. But we'll also be sharing with you a diversity of big game hunts that we pursued right here in Alberta.
Thirdly, we can't be thankful enough for all our generous sponsors that have stepped up to support us throughout our journey, especially considering the economic crunch we're facing out west. Without your support, our dream of having our very own TV show wouldn't have become a reality.
We can't also forget all the landowners out there that granted us permission in allowing us to hunt on their lands. Just one more thing. Right from the get-go, we want to say that we aren't professionals by no means. We don't have all the fancy cameras or the high-tech gear or huge sponsors. Not to mention our camera work and our editing is all self-taught. Yes, there might be times where our footage might be a little shaky or the sound might be off, but at the end of the day, we hope our efforts in capturing and sharing our hunts with you are still entertaining.
There, we got it all in. Now let's not waste any more time and get to that Redemption Ram action.
We have a few stops along the way to pick up the hunting crew, and the first stop was fellow teammate and good friend, Mitch Visser. Once we got all of Mitch's gear loaded up, we were off to Edmonton to stop and pick up our third member of our team, Marty.
Hey!
What's going on?
We're going sheep hunting!
Right on.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh. Here's a bit of stuff there.
Where are we going to put all that?
On your back.
We quickly loaded up Marty's gear and then headed out west to make the long trek towards the Rocky Mountains. I don't think any one of us was tired as we were all running on high excitement and anticipation for what the week had in store for us.
So we finally made it here on our last leg of our journey for tonight anyways. We're here in Grand Cache at my brother's place and now to unpack. So this is the time where we go through all the packs and make sure that we have all the gear in the right packs. And then if there's any room left over, this is where the horse trading begins. Right, little bro?
Yeah.
You said you have room in your pack.
I do.
For like, what, 15 pounds?
Maybe 10.
10's good.
It's good. It's shrinking.
There's actually a contractual agreement.
Agreement, okay. This is a contractual agreement between Martin Toya and Leo Paquin, Mitch Visser, and Cyril Paquin. Here into referred to, you got a grammatical error here, referred to as Zipperlip Club. This contract is being put in place to protect all parties from Zipperlip becoming loose lips. Failure to comply with the conditions in this contract will result in each member of the Zipperlip Club having the right to give Martin one direct.
What?
Unblocked
one direct,
kick. One direct unblocked kick to the groin.
This is probably as good as any time to explain why we chose to call this episode Redemption Ram. It pains me to relive this memory, so I'll make it short and sweet. The season before, my brother Cyril and I were the only ones sheep hunting, and since Cyril had harvested a ram the year before, it meant that I was up to bat. All I can say is, what's worse than missing a ram? How about missing two different rams? And do I even dare mention I fired 3 missed shots at ram number 2? I can tell you firsthand, it was certainly a hard pill to swallow, and I'd be lying if I said those memories weren't ingrained with me all through the off season. Let's just say it provided me some motivation and training for the upcoming season, and thankfully for me, the guys were going to give me one more chance at redeeming myself. So here we are, we've reached another leg of our journey. We've just fueled up and we've had some granola bars and jerky and Gatorade, and everybody seems to be feeling okay, but I think it's kind of the calm before the storm. Everybody knows what's next. You guys might not be able to see it here on TV too well, but way up there is a hill we call BFH, and it's basically a big frickin' hill. It's 900 meters distance traveled, and we get about 450 meters elevation gain, so we're gonna do this, and then right at the top, we're gonna take a break. So the next time you see us, we'll hopefully be at the top. So we conquered BFH once again. Some of us could say we kinda crawled and clawed our way up. But the good news is everybody's resting up. We got the boots off, we're fueling up, we're eating. How does Mitch feel after being away for 2 years on Zipperlip?
Well, it brings back fond memories, but yeah. BFH is a tough go no matter what, whether you do it every year or every 3 years or every year.
What we didn't tell you earlier is BFH is really the base of Zipperlip Creek Mountain where we got our sheep camp. So just another little hop, skip, and a jump. And then we got to get set up for the evening.
That's his phrase for short.
Yeah, short. You know, short.
Easy.
And what about our VSH? Our virgin sheep hunter, Marty. How's he doing? What do you think about BFH?
I wouldn't classify it as successful as Mitch there.
What? You made it. Yeah, you made it.
I made it. The clawing and scratching comment at the beginning was more what I was doing. I'm like, how do these guys go through that stuff?
Yeah, let's get a little bit of R&R, make the last trek, get up there. So after a grueling hike, we finally made it to Zipperlip Creek Camp, just before darkness set in. So we quickly set up the tents, fired up the stoves, and got some much-needed supper to refuel our energy. So it's the morning after getting into camp here, and we're making a water run when there's four guys in camp and the temperatures are warm. So there we were in sheep camp. Day one was the hike in. Day two, we decided to take the day off and tend to some camp chores. Then came day three, which was the day before opening day and a day I don't think any one of us was expecting. But the sheep gods threw us down a lucky bone, as at midday, nine rams came strolling over the mountain and decided to feed directly above camp. Talk about your gift.
Well, it's opening morning here, and we snuck up here in the dark. We got up at 4 a.m., and it looks like the rams have given us a slip. They obviously moved during the night, so we're going to go up further up the mountain and make a circle and see if we can locate them. So hopefully it works out.
Morning again, guys. It's quarter to eight now. We just spotted one of the rams.
Don't go away. We'll be right back for more action on Coyote Country. Have a gander at this beautiful tiger trout.
Join Coyote Country on Facebook for live updates or check us out at coyotecountry.ca.
We just spotted one of the rams. We just bumped over the ridge on the other side of where we started out this morning from, so.
Now for a moment it looked like we were busted by this ram, but thankfully for us, the ram just looked upslope and then relaxed and started to feed again. Now from the glassing we did the day before on the slopes above camp, we immediately recognized this ram as Stumpy, as he was the heaviest and most broomed off ram from the bunch. Luckily for me, Stumpy just happened to fit the description of my dream ram. Now luckily for the rams, they were held up in a small gully where we couldn't sneak up any closer, and taking a risky shot was definitely out of the question. But with the ram staring down slope and getting restless, it can only mean one thing. The rams were about to leave the safety of the gully in exchange for some green grass. And just like that, the tides had turned, and now we were the lucky ones sitting pretty with a view of nine rams well within shooting range. We just had to be patient as they fed and wait for Stumpy to clear the other rams before I threaded a shot into the old ram.
The rams are 400 yards away.
I'm gonna stop right here and say, you know, sheep hunting can be funny and strange all at the same time. One minute, you're all relaxed and glassing rams for hours at a time, and then the next second, suddenly the rams can be off and running. Well, I just summed up our situation, and just like that, it was instantly go time. And I was quickly trying to locate Stumpy in my scope as the rams were nearing a ridge, and if those rams went over that ridge, they'd be gone forever, and so was my chance at redemption.
Yes!
He's down.
You got him. He's down.
You drilled him. Holy smokes, man. You got him.
I got him good.
Oh, awesome.
What did
Stumpy's
he go?
He's down.
He went down.
He went
hard.
Straight down.
Did you get him on video?
I think I got it. I followed him. He fell a little ways there. Oh, man. That was awesome.
Oh, man. That's a good ram, too.
Freaking rights.
We got to go get the boys. Let's go get him. I can't believe the mass. Look at the gap right here. Wow. The bases. The bases on this guy. And the nose. He's definitely been a fighter. And we figure he's about 10 and a half year old ram, which is the high end of what they live out to out here. They don't get much past that, so weeding out the top of the top is always a good thing. What a cranker of a brute of a ram. 415 yard shot. I'm pretty happy with that one shot drop. And got to take this time to thank our sponsors, all our sponsors that have helped us out here on Coyote Country. I know we're a long, long ways from coyotes, but it's the off season, and this is how we do it in the off season. A ram of a lifetime. Doesn't get any better than this.
All right, well, here we got Lee all loaded up. He's got his all the meat, hide, and cape, so he's got a heavy load here. So on our way back to camp now.
It's been a good afternoon. It's about 2 in the afternoon, so by the time we get back to camp, by the time we get washed up, things sorted out, guess what's for supper? Ribs and tenderloin.
Hey, couldn't think of anything better to eat tonight.
The supper of choice for the Zipper Lip crew and the Coyote Country crew. So I guess the next time you'll see us is at camp when we got a nice fire and sizzling up some ribs. We did her, boys.
We did.
This is the part of the show where I say we spent the next few days trying in vain to locate the remaining rams, but unfortunately, we never set sights on those rams ever again. Now, most of you will think this is where the show ends, but there was just one more thing to take care of. You see, we like to have fun on Coyote Country, and every once in a while, we like to pull a prank on each other. Anyways, let's roll the footage, as with the help of Marty, we're about to pull off the mountain mecca of all pranks.
So I got a whisper here, but a couple years ago, I got pranked by my brother and Mitch. And it's been 2 years, and I've been savoring the moment of payback. I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard of prairie oysters. Well, this is Rocky Mountain oysters. So, what we're planning to do is cook them in with our tenderloin and tell them they're shiitake mushrooms. So when you hear us say shiitake mushrooms, that's the cue that they're about to take a mouthful of Rocky Mountain oysters. And they got a phobia about mountain oysters. It's gonna be good. Hopefully we can pull it off.
And then a little bit of...
Yours was 11 and a half, this next one.
And a little bit of shiitake mushrooms. Right on.
Well.
Looks good.
All what was left to do was have Marty serve up the hors d'oeuvres while I captured it all on video for you to witness. But as luck would have it, I hit a major technical glitch as the battery on my sound mic had died and I didn't notice it. Unbelievable. But having said all that, I'm going to try my best to describe to you what's going on as we roll the footage, as the looks on the boys' face is what I call priceless. So here comes Marty right on cue as he starts offering up the hors d'oeuvres, and wouldn't you know it, little bro is the first victim as he jumps at the chance as he can't seem to resist the tasty and tender morsels. Keep an eye on Marty. I'm trying to read lips here, but I believe he's saying, not bad, pretty good, and that he could keep them for himself so he could have seconds for later. I'd say so far so good. Cyril even mentions to Mitch that they're pretty good. And that was all that Mitch needed to hear before he dove in. Mitch appears to be hesitant at first, but one bite and he seems to be hooked and found that the tenderest of the loins was actually quite tasty as well. The prank was going down perfect, and I thought these guys didn't like Rocky Mountain oysters. Wow, Cyril even wants to keep them all for himself, if he only knew. And as if on cue, Cyril takes a morsel and eats it directly into the camera. And I'm telling you, I was biting my tongue pretty hard at this point before I spilled the beans. And all I had to say was, remember a couple years ago when you pranked me? And Cyril instantly knew what he had just eaten, as Marty and I were folded over crying in laughter. Mitch wasn't quite sure yet what he had eaten, but once Cyril filled him in, his reaction was priceless. I'm not sure it's good to laugh that hard after a big meal, but without doubt, this was one of those memories from Zipper Lip Creek Camp that we'd never, ever forget. But after an eventful day, and not to mention some full bellies, we placed another notch onto the old Zipperlip Creek camp sign before we headed off to the tent to catch some much-needed Z's, as tomorrow was a new day.
We got the packs all loaded up and we're ready to head out back to civilization. Cyril, what was your biggest memorable moment of the hunt? Obviously, the ram being the most memorable one.
It's always nice to see a big brother tag out, get his ram, mostly because it means that I'm up next year. It was a great hunt, and I do have to admit, those Rocky Mountain oysters did taste pretty good.
Yeah, but that's what it's all about. We had a great adventure, we had good laughs, and now it's time to hook up the horses. Horse number one, horse number two, horse three, horse four. And get these heavy packs out. So hopefully you enjoyed this week's show, and we'll see you next time.
Coyote Country was proudly presented by CR Backwoods. On next week's episode titled Field of Yotes, we will be joining Coyote Country team member Leo as he gets up close and personal with some early season coyotes.